When was your first SportsCenter? Who'd you do it with, Steve? When was that?
Carl Ravitch, August 8th of 93, so that same year, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll never forget Mike McQuaid, who's still one of my many bosses. We have a lot of bosses, as you know, Rich.
Yes.
And he was producing the show, and in those days, we did the two-shot hi-hello on the middle camera.
Yep.
And then whoever had the lead, you'd look down and do the traditional TV anchor turn.
Yes.
And do, you know, your 25 seconds, 30 second lead in, right? So, and Ravi had only been there like 3 months before me, the grizzled veteran, right? So he gives me this nice buildup from New York and Channel 2 and the fan, blah, blah, blah. We want to welcome our newest anchor, Steve Levy. I say, thanks, Carl. I say a sentence, and then, you know, you're supposed to look down and turn. Well, I must have looked down and not turned. So I did my entire 30 second first lead in on the two shot.
On the wrong camera.
Yes, and so Ravitch is trying to be, you know, comforting and a good partner. He's looking at me. He's looking at the camera. McQuaid is in my ear. Hey, Steve, camera three, you know, trying to be gentle.
Yeah,
I'm definitely nervous, man. It's my first show.
Yeah.
Camera three, look left, you know, nothing. And I was, Rich, there was nothing going to get me off that camera two, that two shot, and until they rolled that video.
Oh.
And we were off and running. But that's, yeah.
When was the last time you see? Have you seen that footage? I mean, does it exist somewhere,
Steve? I'm sure it exists somewhere in the basement in Bristol, but I have not seen it. I see the bulging disc a lot. Nobody brings out the first show is not as popular as the bulging disc. Always a good go-to. You know, when I speak at benefits, Rich.
Yes.
That's my own, you know, I'm not funny, as you know.
No,
so
you
I'm
are. Steve, don't say that.
And so.
No.
That's always my go-to to try to break the ice with a crowd.
Well, and of all the people to have had the back problem and you leave out the S in bulging disc, you know, Randy Johnson, of all people as well, the big unit, right? Is that who had the bulging disc too, Steve?
No, it was not. Not for me. He might still have a bulging disc. But it was,
who was it? Who had the bulging disc?
Maurice Hurst of the Patriots. Maurice Hurst Jr.'s dad. Yeah, it was Maurice Hurst of the New England Patriots. I even tell you this story. This is a good story. So I'm doing a Michigan game, right?
Yes.
Greasy.
Yeah.
And Maurice Hurst Jr. is playing, right? He's a good player and stuff.
Yes.
We're on ABC, and I told the producer, hey, you know, we get to a blowout. It could be fun to roll in and all that stuff. So we wind up rolling it in, and Maurice Hurst Jr. tweets me after the game and says something along the lines of, hey, Steve, I never knew that about my father. So how about and leaves it flat there. So, yeah, that was my Maurice Hurst.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. I think that was one of the stories from Real SportsCenter that made it into that show, the Aaron Sorkin show, Sports Night, right? I think that
did, right?
Like, but they basically said that's on the prompter. It was Josh Charles basically said, I'm not reading it. I forget what it was, but it made Sports Night. That made Sports Night. Back in the
day. Absolutely did. And listen, this was totally on me. It was spelled correctly in the prompter. I just misspoke. I was one letter, Rich. One little letter.
Hey,
make a big deal about
I just told the story just yesterday on yesterday's show that my son is at summer camp right now. My two boys are in the same summer camp. My youngest son did the sports report on the PA system. I heard that story. And I did it. In once upon a time in my camp too, I did the sports report on the PA, but I got basically fired from the job after doing it once because when I was reading the box score of the Philadelphia Phillies back in 1980 or 81, I'd left the letter M out of Mike Schmidt's last name by accident, and they thought I did that on purpose, and I was one and done. So I had my right. Hey man, I know how it feels basically, but I was also in Trails End Camp at the time, not on Sports Center.
Not sitting next to Olbermann.
Olbermann, unfortunately for you, it wasn't a read into a, if I'm not mistaken, it wasn't a read into a highlight. It was just a straight sport, like a straight news read, and you're supposed to throw it to Keith next. And Keith was next, and he had his glasses off and waved the camera back to you, right? Because he was laughing?
Yes, very close. And Olbermann has the line, so I say what I said. And Olbermann says, Steve, do we have any video of that? So now, you know, the camera starts shaking, right, because everybody's laughing. And the other kicker to that story is, and again, you know what? It's Mike McQuaid again. So he's producing that night. And the next story, this is amazing, is about an Asian figure skater who had passed away. Okay, so can you imagine? Now we've totally lost control of the show.
Right.
And in television terms, when you're not going to do a story, it's kill the story.
That's
right?
Kill the story, right?
So that's right. So Quaid says, "All right, kill the Asian figure skater." You know, and, well, she's already dead, and now right in our ears. So we've totally lost it now, and so I'm going through a rip of NFL like season ending, career ending injuries, and trying not to lose to lose it. And Keith absolutely is crying. And the only reason I was there is because Dan took the night off. Dan had, his daughter was graduating or something like that.
Oh, gosh.
So I was filling in for Dan. It was coming out of Monday Night Football. Like, it was the worst possible spot. And I really thought I was going to get fired the next day, Rich. I really did.
Oh, God. So look at the hair. We've got a screen grab of you. Similar. Steve, we got a screen grab of you from that. There's Hurst with the over-the-shoulder of Maurice Hurst Sr. Yep. right there. You don't have that tie anymore, that's for sure. I don't think you have that tie anymore. Look at you.
Too thin?
Look at, no, it's got a hell of a pattern. My gosh, that's
How about me myself? Was I too thin? Or too thin?
Steve, you look great. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.